Are you thinking of having a cosmetic procedure, whether you're considering a non-surgical procedure, like Botox, or cosmetic surgery, such as liposuction? It's vital that you do your research.
For liposuction particularly, you have to remember, it can only deal with localized excess of fat. It can't reduce the BMI from 35 to 25. You know, it just can't do those things.
This series looks at real-life stories with accurate and useful information to get clued up on cosmetic procedures. Let's talk liposuction.
I had liposuction purely on the fact that I was a bigger girl. I lost weight. I still had fat pockets that didn't want to budge. I feel like no matter what I look like or how I look, I don't think I'll ever be happy with it. One surgeon actually turned me away and said to me, I can't do it. If I do it and take too much fat out, you're going to be left with two skin pockets. I probably should have listened to him, but it was not what I wanted to hear. I went abroad. I went to Turkey. I found somebody else, and I didn't even have a proper consultation. I literally sent some photos through email. When I told them what the other surgeon had said to me, they turned around and said, oh, no, that won't happen. That would only happen if we took loads of fat out. And obviously they probably took loads of fat out because I've got pockets. Listen to the professionals. Listen to those that have got good reviews and are probably highly known, rather than, well, he's cheaper and he said he'll do it and I'm going to go for that one. Sometimes I think I should have listened to the first guy I see, but I didn't, and that's on my head.
All types of liposuction and body contouring techniques are intended to remove areas of unwanted body fat and for body reshaping. The effects of liposuction are generally long-lasting, providing you maintain a healthy weight.
First of all, check to make sure they're on the GMC. Go online, Google searches, other patients may have written reviews on them, and have a good consultation with the practitioner. Don't just have one consultation, go and have two or three, because if three different doctors say a different thing, then you might want to start rethinking your strategy. It's important to then have a cooling off period, discuss it with your family to make sure that, you know, it is something that everyone is supportive of. Make sure you've told your work, you've got enough people at home to look after you. And obviously the aftercare, you have to ask the doctors what the aftercare is, what's to come back, how often they'll see you.
Liposuction is classed as a surgical procedure and must be carried out by a doctor registered with the General Medical Council. In England, the provider must also be registered with the Care Quality Commission. There are various risks and complications that can occur with liposuction, including burns, infections, and sometimes skin may look lumpy or uneven. Remember, all cosmetic procedures carry some level of risk and can impact on both your physical and emotional health.
Liposuction really works if you've got young, supple skin. So the skin quality needs to be good, and it's not really suitable for patients who've undergone big fluctuations of weight.